motivational speaker in Scottsdale, and we spent the day there. And when we were done, we drove to his house, but Deanna was there waiting for him for some reason to visit or something. And he was so scared that she would see him in my car that I practically had to keep the car rolling and kick him as I drove by at his house. And he's like, don't even put it in park, just roll up real quick. And he jumped out and shut the door, and he's like, no, go, go, go. So I was like, okay. And I just kind of laughed at that. That was August 18.
So I see the type of relationship. I mean, it's exactly what I thought it was.
Well, his thing with Deanna was, and I don't think that he had anything physical going on with her. I don't know. I don't think so. I know that for a time there was, and then she's pretty strong in that category, I think, as far as her values and standards go.
So why this trip this time? I know you said he canceled on you even coming up here in the first part of June, right? Why did you end up going there then? Is it because he couldn't go and you guys still wanted to see each other?
Well, when his trip the second time got postponed, it was probably last week of May that you know, it was kind of obvious that he wasn't going to come then. But he said, listen, after Cancun, I have like 2 weeks that I have nothing going on before I go to D.C. And he's like, I think that's the best time. He's like, I'm going to see if it works out for my friends up north, which would have been, you know, Chad Perkins, his friend, and now his wife. And we can do it all then. And I said, all right. But at that time, I was like, whatever. We'll see. I might just not see you until I go back to Utah. And everyone convenes it. And you there, which everyone's going to do at the end of the month.
So did he know you were coming the first part of June?
I wasn't even, like, I had been talking with Ryan at this point. And obviously there's a distance there, and that was difficult, and he really wanted to spend time with me, and I really wanted to spend time with him, and it just seemed like he had made a few comments, when am I going to come out there? And, you know, I was like, as soon as you want, you know, but I didn't think he was serious. And
is this Ryan you're talking about?
Ryan Burns.
Yeah.
So finally, things began to work out at Casa Ramos with my schedule, which is the Mexican restaurant, and I have a 3-day weekend there. So I thought, I'll take this opportunity and go see Ryan. And that was my intention.
What happened when you left? Why did you go the other way? That's my question.
You know,
why go to see Travis if you're going to see Ryan as well? And did Travis know you were coming? He knew? I saw you kind of shake your head a little bit. I don't.
This is hard.
It's okay. Did he know you were coming? Did you guys talk on the phone? What was the discussion about?
Gordon Hinckley, mostly.
The last conversation you had?
The last long one. We talked a little bit prior to.
Did you guys talk when you were en route to Phoenix?
Yeah. Just briefly. Told him my phone was dying, which was true. I thought I left my charger in Monterey with Matt. I really honestly thought that I left my charger there, and I had been talking all day between just on the phone. I take lots of pictures of myself, and I know it's...
I noticed.
Because I'm kind of picky about it, and I guess I take them and I'm like, delete, delete, delete. I will take like 20, I'll be like, delete, delete, delete.
Keep one?
Yeah, keep two or three or one or none, depending. And so I talked a little bit with John Dixon, who I was maybe going to go to San Diego. There's another place on the list there, too.
That was in the same trip?
Yeah, it's a little ambitious, but I thought...
Gosh, that's like 2,800 miles.
It doesn't bother me, except I think I put like 2,400 miles in the car.
I can't stand driving.
Yeah,
45 minutes somewhere.
Yeah, where are you flying out of?
Oregon.
Medford?
Oh.
Yeah, it's a good, just about an hour. Anyway, it's a pretty drive. So it was a little ambitious, but I like road trips, and sometimes I have a realistic view of things, unrealistic about how, about my time, and I tend to show up a little later than expected, which is not unusual for me, but.
So he knew you were coming, and he was expecting you. Now obviously you guys had, you know, a little encounter, and is that when those pictures were taken? Did he even show you those pictures?
I feel really powerless in here. Do you know what my family is doing today?
No.
Do you know if they're good? Or?
I haven't talked to them today. I know they're worried about you. Everybody's just kind of in limbo right now. So obviously there was nobody else at the house when you got there. His roommates were gone. Well, there was Napoleon, but...
He's a person too.
Yeah, I got to meet Napoleon.
Oh, he's so awesome.
But nobody else was there?
I think his roommates were there.
You think his roommates were there? Were their cars there? You would have had to have seen their cars. You parked in the driveway, right?
Yeah.
One roommate parks it in the garage, and the other one parks it outside.
Well, I know Zach would park on the street a lot when I lived there before. And he pulled his car into the garage whenever he would work on it.
What makes you think his roommates were there?
I asked him.
What did he say? Who was home?
He said they were there. But I don't know who. The reason I asked, because it's kind of an indication of how quiet we have to be.
What time was that? Do you remember what time you rolled in?
Mm. 3 o'clock. A.M. Still dark.
Wednesday morning? Sneaky, you go up there and your roommates doesn't even know that you're there.
I do that many, many, many nights.
How did they not see your car?
I don't know. I was parked.
Oh, you know what? Zach was house sitting for his girlfriend. His girlfriend was on a trip with, was on a cruise with her parents, and he was staying the night at, I think he stayed the night at,
That makes sense, because I want to say that his roommate, he said his roommate was home, but I don't remember, but I think he said one roommate.
One roommate.
Home.
Enrique, he gets up about 5:30, 6
correct,
o'clock
then
in the morning.
And Enrique has the room that shares the wall with Travis's room, which is like...
Yes.
And, you know, it's a KB home. Travis always says the walls are really, really thin.
Yes. They skimp on that part. Yeah, so Enrique was home, so you went in about 2 or 3 in the morning. But he gets up about 6, and no, he leaves the house about 6 in the morning. And he didn't notice anything different. Did you guys spend the whole day together then? That following day? Did you guys go anywhere? Just stayed in the house?
Slept.
Well, after a long trip, I'd sleep too.
Trying to stay up all night waiting. He was watching something on YouTube. Some stupid video. He's like, you gotta see this. And I'm watching it, and I'm like, this is so boring. I'm like, what? I was like, what's the point of that? And he's like, just stupid, pointless stuff. I'm like, okay. I, you know, I guess everyone's gotta have their time to binge out. Being so driven and deep as he is, portrays himself to be, it's just funny that he watches stuff like that. It wasn't anything profane or bad or vulgar. It's just like people like dancing, but they had like boxes of foil on their head. It was just like weird, like robotic kind of music.
The pictures that I showed you of you lying on a bed and stuff, is that when those were taken that day?
Yeah, we also made a video. We deleted it.
Video on that.
On his camera.
On that camera.
Did you get it?
Videos are hard to get once they're erased. They take up so much room.
Yeah.
And whereas pictures are a little different.
Yeah.
What happened after that? What went wrong? I know that the last photos of him were taken about 5:20, 5:30. And you said he doesn't like you to take pictures of him and stuff.
He was very private about the shower. Like we.
Is that why you were taking pictures of him in the shower?
No, no.
Trying to get back at him.
No.
I'm surprised he allowed you to take pictures of him in the shower. The first few looked like he wasn't too comfortable, but. Obviously, whatever you were saying to him made him a little more comfortable.
I remember all that. It's pretty clear.
You remember that? What went wrong? Did he say something to you? Were you angry about something? Were you frustrated? What was it? Something happened at that point, and I don't know what it was.
What are they going to do with the rental car? Are they going to bring it here?
There were several photos of him, and the last one that we have is him sitting in the shower. And that's when I think it happened. He was sitting down, looking up at you. What did you do? What happened, Jody? We've gone this far. Did you plan on doing that the whole time? And I don't understand why you took a gun with you.
Oh, I didn't.
Where is that gun from then? Where did you get it? Everybody says he didn't have one. Where did you get it? If you didn't take it. Did he have one in the house?
Not to my knowledge.
Then where did you get it? Did you bring it with you? Did you get it there in Arizona?
I didn't ever have it, actually. I didn't like have it in my possession.
Then who had it? If you had it and Travis didn't have it, then who had it? Jody, please.
I can't.
Why not? Are you protecting somebody else? Why would somebody else do this?
I don't know.
Did someone catch you there? Someone not expecting you to be there?
See my car.
Then who was it?
I don't know. Listen, I can tell you. I can tell you everything that I know or that I remember.
Okay. What do you remember? From the time you were taking the pictures to the time you left, what happened? What happened after that last picture was taken? If you want me to believe that somebody else was there, you have to show me. You have to explain to me what happened. Otherwise, it was just you. And if that's the case, that's okay. That's okay as well.
It's better if everyone thinks that.
If everyone thinks that it was just you. No, it's not.
It is, really. You have no idea.
I do have no idea.
No, you have no idea.
You're going through your own things right now. If somebody else was there with you, we need to know that. Why would somebody do that? Just because you're there with Travis.
He didn't say.
Hmm?
He didn't say.
He didn't say?
They.
What was the first thing they did to him? You were there. You saw it. What was the first thing you saw?
I actually didn't see it. I heard it first.
Was there an argument? No?
Not between Travis and I.
Any argument between anybody?
Yeah. Is there any way I can see those pictures? I just...
No, not right now.
Can I see him soon? I will. You know.
You need to start letting me know what happened. Okay. You're telling me that some other people were there. You know how much that concerns me.
I don't know who they were. They know where I live.
Mm-hmm.
Or they know where my parents are in Oregon. I don't know if they know where my grandparents are, but they got my address. And they know where my family is.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
So you're trying to say you're doing this to protect your family? Why would someone do this to you and to him?
I don't think they really intended to do anything to me.
You're saying somebody followed you all the way to Arizona from here?
No, I don't think that. I think I was an element of surprise for them.
You were an element of surprise? So they didn't expect
you to be
there? I'm
guessing. I don't think so.
They didn't expect you to be there?
I mean, they had to see my car.
Is it someone who lives in Mesa locally?
I didn't recognize any of them.
Well, you have to give me a motive. Why would they do this? Were they going after Travis? For what reason? You tell me this, but you give me no reason.
They didn't discuss much. They just argued.
About what?
About whether or not to kill me.
For what reason?
Because I'm a witness.
A witness of what?
Of him. Of Travis.
Of Travis's murder.
Yeah, but I didn't really witness it. Didn't see much.
Okay.
Oh.
You need to make this believable, because it is not believable to me right now. You need to give me something.
Okay. Listen.
I am listening, Jody.
I am listening.
And it doesn't make any sense to me.
It's fine, because my family will,
Well, help us protect your family. If that's the case.
They got my driver's license. It has a P.O. box on it.
Mm-hmm.
Then they got my registration out of my purse, which was in the purse that I was using at the time. And it has my parents' address on it.
Why would they do this? You see where I'm coming from? Why? What kind of beef did they have with him? Or was it with you, or... You need to make this believable. People just don't go in somewhere and kill somebody for no reason and then let a witness go. That doesn't happen. They've already killed one person, why not just take care of the other?
Well, yeah.
You know who they are, if you're telling me the truth.
I don't know them.
Then I don't believe you either. And I can't. You can't expect me to.
Okay.
I want to.
I wasn't planning on going to Travis's house. I was gonna go to Santa Cruz. Well, I wasn't even planning to go to Santa Cruz. I was gonna go to Monterey, but by the time I called Matt, he's like, we're in Santa Cruz, meet us here. And I said, okay. So I went to the red room there, just we'll kind of hang out for the locals. The younger kids our age, sort of 20-somethings and 30-somethings. And I stayed the night in Monterey that night, got up the next morning and visited with Daryl and his son before he went to school. Drove, this was Tuesday, the 5th, 3rd. And I'm driving to LA, hadn't heard back from Laura yet, but that's what it was. It wasn't until I got to LA where I thought, I was looking at my map, and Utah wasn't really on there, but, I mean, Arizona, but because it was to Utah, the MapQuest directions I printed. I just see, like, I've seen The Sopranos, and they're not mafia or anything, but, you know, there's a part of me inside that thinks they're never going to come after my family.
From what you're telling me, and from what I know about Travis and all his dealings, There's no reason anybody would go after him. Nothing. So what you're telling me about two people coming in, or however many people coming in and taking care of him and letting you go, is just so far-fetched. I can't believe it. Why would they do this to him? What were they arguing about? What did they say? Their details.
They didn't say a lot. They were white Americans, from what I could tell. They had, what do you call those things? They're like beanies, but they cover your whole face. They've got like holes for your nose and your mouth and your eyes. And they were, one was black. I think they were both black, or maybe dark blue or something. Anyway, it wasn't until I was in LA and Laura wasn't getting back to me and it was already like 9 something that I was like, maybe I will just go see Travis briefly. And I called Ryan and said, my phone was about to die. And I tried getting hold of Matt. I got his voicemail. I was going to ask him if my charger was there and if he could save it or mail it or something. I had a wall charger, I think, and I was just going to charge it later, I guess, when I got somewhere. Anyway, I did call Travis, and I said, guess what? And he said, what? I said, I'm coming to Arizona tonight. And there was silence, and he goes, really? And I said, yeah. Well, what made you change your mind? And I just said, because I think I just told him I missed him or something. But... And I would have said, because you're too compelling, but, like, he's already got a big enough head with that stuff. So I showed up, and he was watching YouTube on his computer, on his laptop in the office. We watched that for a little while, and he was very happy to see me. Napoleon barked, but he always barks when somebody walks in, and then Napoleon was really happy to see me. He gets so excited, his whole body jiggles.
Yeah.
And I just do this thing to his butt where you just kind of push him on the side, and he goes around in circles over and over and over until he realizes, hey, stop putting me in circles. So it was a good reunion. I told him I was tired, I think, because I don't know what his intentions were, or what he thought my intentions were at the time, like if we were going to do anything, but I was very exhausted from the trip, and I just said, I think I'm just going to sleep for a little while, and he said, that's fine. So I had slept pretty well the day before, but I was tired from driving all night, so I slept, and he slept, and we must have slept till about 1.
In the afternoon?
Must have been around then. His roommate was home when I got there. I didn't ever see his roommate though, so I think I was asleep by the time he got up and left. Okay, if you don't believe me, that's okay.
I'm trying.
I'm just saying
really
that
hard.
You know, it sounds to me like I'm already in the system. Pretty far in.
Yeah.
I'm not getting out anytime soon. And as long as the rep falls on me, I think that...
It's not good. Don't do this.
No, I'm just saying. I think that as long as that is... There's less of a chance that my little brother is going to be hurt, or my mom, or my dad, or my sister that live there.
Okay, we'll continue with the story.
Anyway.
About 1 o'clock.
Yeah, we had sex. Couple of times. Once was in his bed, and once was again downstairs in his office. And I don't know what he was looking at, some pictures that I had brought for him. But he has a virus on his computer, so. When you click the start menu on Windows XP or newer, 2000 or whatever, you have like my music, my pictures, my computer.
Yeah.
You can usually click on my computer and then go to the disk drive and open that. You'd click the Windows and it would come up, but none of those my this music computer's picture,
yeah.
None of that would come up. So he had some kind of virus that he was dealing with. And then his screensaver was a bunch of little bugs eating up his screen. It was just weird. And he said that was from the virus too. I was like, that's a cute screensaver. He's like, yeah, it's my stupid virus. So for some reason that was frustrating for both of us because we couldn't look at the pictures. And they were from a lot of our church history trips, which are on my other external drive, which I haven't been able to access for a long since after Christmas because I just quit. And I just haven't had the money to spend to get all that stuff back.
So you guys worked with that for a while? Or?
Yeah, we had 3 discs, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, 3. And...
So what time is this now? You guys are messing with the computer?
I don't really remember. It was after we had done
a couple
it.
Hours
yeah.
or
yeah.
an hour or so later?
Yeah, maybe.
Okay.
Afternoon. I just, he had been cleaning his house. So I wasn't sitting on the couch. Usually I would just chill on the couch downstairs, if no one was home. But he had chairs and all that stuff all over the couch. He was cleaning the floors or something. Fed Napoleon. I don't know if he made phone calls or not or what he was doing on the internet, but at one point he was gonna go up and take a shower and it took a lot of convincing prior when he was shaving.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, I got some ideas and they didn't turn out good at all, not like I wanted to. But I thought that I could get some cool pictures of him shaving. It's because he does the whole old-fashioned thing with, this little, I don't know how it works. He liked it, though, apparently, because he used it for his profile picture on MySpace. So those interrupts go. I was going to do that again later, but I asked him if I could do pictures of him in the shower, and he's like, no. I was like, I just have an idea. I have a couple ideas. And he's like, well, what do you mean? And I was like, I said, I have this. I saw this thing in a Calvin Klein ad once that looked really good. And so he was, you're right. He wasn't very comfortable at first. He goes, he's standing there and he's all, I feel gay.
He has that look on his face, though.
So some I deleted and some I kept taking. And some he looked really good, I thought. The one that you showed me yesterday of him looking right at you,
Water.
I think that's a great picture.
That's
he
a
hates
picture.
It. I don't know what he hates about that. I think it's a very good picture of him.
So you were taking pictures and showing them?
Yeah. Yeah. He's all, let me see. Show him. His shower door was open. And his water pressure in that shower isn't that great, so it's not like water was going everywhere.
Picture was taken.
He was kneeling down in the shower. I don't remember him. If this is his shower and the sink is over here, I was right here taking pictures. And I don't really know what happened after that exactly, except I think he was shot.
Where were you?
If this is his shower, and he's sitting here, if this is his shower, and he's sitting here, I was, right here on my knees, and his bathtub was right here, and I was taking him here, and I was just going through the pictures, and I heard this loud ring. And I don't really remember, except Travis was screaming. I think I got knocked out, but I don't think it was that long. I know I got knocked in the head, and I've gotten knocked in the head once by my dad when he was just really mad, and it wasn't he didn't knock me in the head, he just pushed me against the wall, and I hit my head, and I fell. But he, in this case, I think it was similar, because he was screaming, and I was by the bathtub, and he was holding his head, and there were 2 people there, and
what'd you say?
I remember putting my hand on his back because he was on all 4 of his knees. He was on his knees like this, doing something like this or something, like, I don't know. And I was like, are you okay? What's going on? What's going on? He's like, go get help. Go get help. And I said, okay. And I turned around, there were two people there. One was a guy and one was a girl. I couldn't tell that at first, but you could just see one was a girl, and I assumed the other was a guy because their build, and then their voices. I don't remember what they were wearing, like maybe jeans.
What did they say?
One was in all black, one was in jeans.
Did they say anything?
Yeah, the girl wanted to kill me too.
What did she say? What words did you hear? What phrases?
Who is that? Who is that? I thought he was by himself or alone or something, and he was like, shut up, just finish it, and Travis was screaming the whole time. He wasn't screaming like a girl, he was just like he was in pain, like he was like shocked, like, oh, you know. He wasn't really moving though, he was just staying kind of still on the floor.
Then what happened?
Well, as soon as he said, go get help, and I turned around, and they were there, and...
Where were they?
They were in the bathroom.
Where at the bathroom? Not the hallway or in the bathroom?
The girl was in the hallway, kind of. And the guy was more toward in the bedroom. But like still in the bathroom, like on the tile carpet area, right there where it starts.
Okay.
And he started coming in toward the bathroom too, and I...
What'd you do? What happened? What happened, Jody? What did you see?
I took it out like a little bitch.
You took off?
I ran, and he stopped me, but
he stopped you?
And Travis, he was still like conscious and still alive, and
but you just left them there?
No, I ran into the closet because there's two doors and they were sort of in the hallway already, and he stopped me and he didn't touch me, he was just held the gun to my head and he was like, you don't go anywhere, and he told the other girl to finish it. I didn't see, but he was like, I didn't think he was saying a lot, but
what happened?
He told me to stay there and not to move.
And where was that, in the closet?
No, it was I was like this. Sorry.
Here. Is this bedroom? Okay, and then you got the long hallway down to this bathroom, the sink. And then you have the closet here.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have a shower.
Mm-hmm.
And then the bathtub right there. And then there's the
toilet
right there. Okay, this is the sink. In his bedroom is, well, actually there's a closet door there.
Mm-hmm.
In his bedroom.
Yes, exactly. And so his closet is kind of like this
partition. Mm-hmm.
So I ran this way because he was walking this way and she was already right here. And then he stopped me here and he said, don't move. And Travis was here. Or somewhere aroundabouts, and he left the room for a minute, and I didn't have my stupid phone because it wasn't charged. And Travis's phone was downstairs, and I didn't know. His roommates, I didn't think, were home at the time. So, like, I was just trying to think if there's any way I could call 911 or call or get out of the house. There's no way out except down the stairs. His windows are, they're two stories for one, and they're just, they were hard to get to. He had stuff here, and blinds, and screens, and window coverings, and, I mean, from the outside. And
okay.
I just, she was over him, and I just rushed her, and I pushed her, and
there was what?
Travis was bleeding everywhere.
What was she doing to him? Because he'd been shot at this time, right?
Yeah, but he was still alive. Mm-hmm. He was still conscious, even. Like,
still talking.
Oh, he wasn't talking or saying much, but I could tell. He was breathing. He seemed like he was breathing calmly, I think. He wasn't like, he was just there. Mm-hmm. I don't really remember. It's such a blur.
Okay. And so you did what now? You pushed her?
Mm-hmm. She's bigger, a little bit bigger than me, not really in size, but height.
And what happened?
Oh, it didn't really deter her.
Did she have any weapons on her at all?
Yeah.
What'd she have?
I thought she was the one with the gun, but maybe she had the gun, but he had a gun. So either there were two guns or one gun, I don't know.
Well, she's the one who shot him though, right? She was the one here, and he was back here at that time when you saw them.
I would think so, because, I mean, I don't know, I got hit here somewhere. I don't know. Because when I woke up, he was screaming. And I saw her at this point, like right here, and walking either back, she must have been walking back this way. And I saw him sort of following. And that's when he's like, finished. And I started running this way, and he stopped me, and then he left the room for a couple of minutes.
Why did he leave?
Maybe just, I don't know. I don't know.
Okay. So what happened after you pushed her?
I got Travis, and he wasn't, like, standing up, really. He wasn't really doing much, I was trying to get him, and she came back. I got him kind of far, like right here. She came back, and he was just... He was starting to just get weaker and weaker. And this guy came back in. And she said that they needed to do me too, because I was there. And he's like, no, that's not why we're here. Yeah. He had my purse, which I had on the dresser here prior, somewhere.
And what did they do after this? After you guys reached this? Just try to stick with the incident, so what was going on?
She came after me, and he stopped her. And she didn't get me.
How was she gonna get you? Did she have a weapon?
She had a knife.
Okay. You said she had a gun before.
I don't know if she had a gun. I think, because I am guessing, I know that he had a gun. I don't know if she had a gun or not.
So she was basically the aggressor.
Yeah, unless he took a shot too. I don't know.
But it seems like from what you're telling me, she was the aggressive one and he was the more passive.
Yeah, I mean, there was definitely aggression as far as, I mean, I don't know what you define aggression by, but like, there was definitely a sternness, and I wasn't, like, just free to walk out of there. Like, hey, it's cool, you know, and it wasn't anything like that.
Then what happened?
They had an argument back and forth, and she wanted to kill him, and he didn't.
Why didn't they kill you? Just because he said...
He said that's not what we're here for.
Did they say why they were there?
No. But it was obvious they were there for him. They didn't say why.
So it seemed like they knew him, obviously.
Yeah, but he didn't seem to know them. I mean, he was a little out of it. Plus, they had masks on anyway. But he didn't express any kind of recognition.
I could talk.
He was able to say, go get help. Mm-hmm. And at one point, he said, go to my neighbor's house. Go to my neighbor's house. So that if you... there was just no way.
Did you see them hurt him anymore? Other than a gunshot.
She had a knife, and I don't know. He was bleeding everywhere. It was like when she rushed me afterward. Or she came back. I rushed her, but she kind of came back at me.
Why didn't she?
Travis and I were right about here, maybe? I don't know. Halfway? I don't know. And there was a little bit of a struggle with her and I. I was so scared. I'm not a person who fights. I'm not a person who knows really about self-defense. I took some classes once, but it was like 8 years ago, and I've never been consistent with it.
Okay.
So I wasn't sure. I just knew I had to hold on to her hands because she had a knife.
What hand did she have it in?
She had it in this hand, but a little her right, I guess. So.
Her right. What happened? So you didn't see her hurt him anymore. He was just bleeding. Where did he end up?
When I tried getting him here, he said, go get help. And when I came back this way, pushed her, and he said, go to my neighbors. And I wasn't like, no, but I wasn't gonna leave. I couldn't leave without him. I was trying. I felt stupid already for trying to run this way. I was gonna go to a phone. And he was like, I just said, come on. You know, he was naked, but I didn't care. Just come on. And he's like, I can't. I said, come on. He's like, I can't feel my legs. And they wouldn't let me be by him.
Were you clothed at that time, or were you also nude?
Yeah, I was clothed.
Are those the pants that I showed you the other day on that camera?
I don't think I have pants like that. I don't know. I've got a lot of clothes. I'm trying to remember the clothes that I took to that trip. I do have another pair of striped pants, and they're gray though with a black stripe. I don't think they were those. I don't know.
Okay. So what happened after that? They had a conversation about killing you two and then they decided not to.
She really, really, really wanted to.
What happened then?
From there, I was here, like his armoire, whatever it's called, with his TV was here. Mm-hmm. And I was right about here, and I had to stay here. And I was calling his name and they were like, shut the hell up. And I was just, I don't know if I was crying. It was all just like, it was so weird. He was going through my purse.
Mm-hmm.
And he pulled out my wallet and he just took some cash. I had, though, my cash stashed in the jeans I had worn, like a good chunk of it, not like $80, stashed in 420s in the back of my jeans pockets, which were in my backpack. But I had some cash in here, not all of it, though.
Okay.
So he took that, and
and what happened?
He was...
What was she doing?
She was, like, right here that time.
Doing what? He's over here taking stuff from your wallet, from your purse. You're here. She's down the hall.
She wasn't far. It's not a far distance. There was part of me, I think, that was just... I was sitting, and I was just, like... I didn't know what to say. Like, would you beg for your life? Do you say, who are you guys? I'm powerless because I don't have any way to stop them. They were just more powerful.
Well, continue so on. So
figured,
once he took stuff from there, what did he do?
She was, I don't know what she was doing, but she was arguing with him and talking with him and saying.
What were they saying?
She's like, it wasn't like super yelling, it was kind of like hushed but
mm-hmm.
intense. Like, you need to da-da-da, shut up, it's not over here. Things like that. And he grabbed my wallet and he was looking through it. He just took the cash, put it in his pocket. He got my registration out of my wallet,
mm-hmm.
and he said,
what do you say?
He said, you must be that bitch from California.
Mm-hmm.
And he was going like this with my, registration, and he said, if you ever, ever, ever say anything about this, that they'll do to my family the same way and me. And I didn't care so much about me at that point. He said, you need to leave. And don't you call anybody. And don't you say anything. And don't you act like anything happened. He said, I'm giving you one chance. And she said, she's gonna rat us off. She's gonna say something. And he was like, shut up. He was like, you get one chance.
Is that when you left?
I said, leave now. And part of me didn't want to leave. Travis was still alive. He was still, he wasn't moving a lot, but he was still alive. I could see that he was still.
Did you leave at that point?
I left the room.
And where did you go?
I went downstairs, but I didn't have all my clothes.
What did you leave there?
Well, Travis said I had some stuff there. I didn't see what it was. He said it was in his closet. So there were clothes in mine. But All I had was my purse and my backpack. I left those, and I went outside. I just wanted to get help. He told me that if I didn't say anything, that I wouldn't even live to regret it, but that I would regret it.
No idea why they did this to him. You have to know something about it.
I didn't think what else was said.
Anything that clicked in your mind? Because why would anybody do this to him? He does nothing but help people. Everybody likes him. Doesn't owe people money. No people like that anyway.
No.
He doesn't get involved in things he's not supposed to get involved in. He doesn't do drugs. Doesn't seem like a robbery.
No, it doesn't.
Burglary.
I was wondering if they took my stuff to make it look that way. But then he told me to leave. And, you know, Travis usually keeps his cash in his wallet.
So you didn't see what happened to him then?
I just saw that.
Did you get hurt at all? You said you were fighting with her.
Yeah.
What happened to you?
She cut me.
Where at?
My hand.
Let me see. Where at?
You
can
actually
you
can't
me?
See it. If you look in a... My finger isn't the same, though. I was...
Let me see. Where did it get cut?
Conveniently, it was right on the crease.
Right there on the crease?
Can you see? Well, it's kind of a purpler color, I guess.
This one here.
This, which is...
Yeah, right on the crease.
Well, there's a vein on this one, maybe. I don't know.
Is this one here?
Yeah.
It's a little slice there.
Yeah.
Just a small one? Or was it pretty deep?
I don't know how deep it was, but my finger hurt for a while.
Okay, so like right in that crease that you... Right, across both of them?
Not my middle finger. It cut this one a little, but not as much. This is where it really went. I don't know how it happened that all these other fingers were missed, but this one, maybe that, I don't know. This one. Like, I still can't close this finger all the way. It's as close as it goes. Whereas this one goes like that.
Mm-hmm.
Also, my CTR ring used to fit both fingers, and I can't get it on this finger anymore.
So it cut pretty deep, then?
I guess if you feel it, squeeze it. It just feels like bone, like there's nothing abnormal there.
Mm-hmm.
But again, like, my CTR ring slides right on this finger, and it used to slide right in off this finger, and I just can't fit a ring on here.
Okay.
It's a bigger size now.
What about this hair? What's that from?
That's my cat.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure. She scratches me a lot.
So, when you were told to leave, you left? Did you get in your car and drive away?
I always have my keys. My keys are on. I'll have a little clip on them. And I do that because I'm very, very spacey.
Did you see any other cars in the driveway or on the street? Any vehicle descriptions you can give us?
No. Not that I... Not that I really... Not that I... I don't think his roommate's around.
And you just left. You didn't run to the neighbors. You didn't try calling. You knew they were in his house. You had time to run to a neighbor. Why didn't you do that?
I was really scared.
Okay.
I was really freaked out of my mind.
Okay. I don't believe you. I came in here hoping that you would tell me the truth. And this is not the truth, Jody.
This is all I know.
This is, does not make any sense. Does not make any sense.
That's all I know.
Nothing changes for me.
I didn't think it would. I feel responsible because I feel that I could have done more. feel that I should have gotten help. I feel that I should have been stronger.
You feel responsible because you did this.
I did not
Jody,
kill Travis.
You did. You did. And there's nothing you can say that'll change my mind at this point. This is an elaborate story which does not make any sense. Two people come in, first two white males, and then later you change it to...
No, I don't think I ever said white male.
Yes, you did.
When?
At the beginning of the story.
Oh, it was one.
And then you change it, oh no, one's a female.
Oh, one was female the whole time. I said I wasn't sure at first, but you could tell by their build.
Okay. It doesn't make any sense to me. And there's no reason anybody would go after him. There's nothing in his past, nothing in his, at that time that he was going through that would cause somebody to do that to him. And the fact that they left you alive and let you go, that never happens. Why would anybody do that? Why would somebody risk the chance of getting caught, just letting you run out the front door when they're upstairs in this house, killing somebody? Knowing that you could just run across the street and tell somebody. It doesn't make any sense. Does it make any sense to you? It doesn't, does it?
No, they argued about it. It doesn't make sense. I thought for sure I was dead.
I was hoping that you were going to be completely truthful with me today, but obviously that's not the case. I know you were there. I know you had some situation go on with him that got out of control. And the cut that you're showing me there, it's pretty obvious how that happened. I've seen that before. That happens when a knife slips through someone's hand because of blood. It's slippery. And it cuts. That's what that is. I've done this for a long time, and this is the most far-fetched story I've ever heard, and it's not going to help you. Is that how you want to leave this?
I just don't want my family to get hurt.
Your family will not get hurt. They will not get hurt. The way you're hurting your family is by not coming forward and telling me the truth. There is a reason why you did this, and you just refused to tell me why. Maybe because you are cold and calculated, and you went there intentionally to do this, and you're ashamed of it. You're so ashamed that you will come up with a story to try to hide it.
I was there that day, but I didn't take Travis's life.
Haven't convinced me. I hope you can convince the jury, but I doubt it very seriously. Because there's no evidence of anybody else being there. Nobody. And we're still not done looking at all the evidence. We still have other things to check in the lab, and other blood swabs and other things like that. And every time they call me and tell me, hey, we've checked this, points at Jody. Hey, we've checked that, that points at Jody. Nothing points at anybody else. Do you want to be truthful with me? If not, we can just end it now. And we'll just leave it the way it is.
I know that it's obvious I was there.
No, it's obvious that you committed a crime, that you hurt
There's
Travis.
There's no reason
no,
for me to hurt him.
It's not like that. It's. I know that you did this, and you refused to tell me why.
There's no
you
reason.
You refused to tell me why. There's no reason somebody else would come in and do this to him. There's no motive whatsoever. You haven't found any.
What is my motive?
Jealousy, anger, fear, if you're being alone, angry at him for not keeping you in his life. I don't know. That's why I'm trying to figure it out. There are so many motives with you. Too many. We know you had a 25 auto. You guys reported it stolen. Recovered the ammunition and it matches. We recovered a shell casing. It matches the ammunition. Prints, your blood, your hair, the motive. You were there.
I wasn't jealous of anything. I was a little bit envious that he was going to Cancun, but that wasn't the reason. Like, I could go to Cancun. It's not cheap to go to Mexico. I mean, it's not expensive to go to Mexico.
You were probably standing above him when he was in the shower. And you shot him in the head.
I was kneeling down beside him looking at the pictures.
And then you had a knife. And you stabbed him. Several times. Yes, you did. Jody. Tell me the truth. Please. Or if you want, we can stop here. It doesn't matter. You've given me so much already. Why stop? Do you want to? Do you want to continue? Do you want to tell me the truth? What did you do with the gun?
I never had it in my possession.
Joni. You did.
Never. I don't have it.
Yeah, you don't have it. You know, people say that when they know of the gun. They've seen the gun. They've touched the gun. You don't have it.
I saw the gun.
Yeah. But you had it before. You've touched it. You've used it. I know you have.
I don't think I've ever even fired a gun. I've done bows and arrows, but not guns and water guns, yeah, but not a real gun. And the gun that I got on Friday was never used.
So you're going to continue to tell me that you didn't do this to him?
Did not kill Travis.
I believe you did. I truly believe you did. And there's nothing showing that anybody else did this. Been in so many scenes and so many investigations, and there's always, always some type of evidence left behind, no matter how careful somebody is. And in this case, there was evidence. Not pointing at anybody else, just you. And that's what I have to go by. And that's what my report's gonna say.
Okay. I had planned to hurt him in any way. I'm not the rightest person, but I don't think I could stab him. I think I would have to shoot him continuously until he was dead, if that were my intention. And again, I bring up the gloves again, but I would have to wear gloves because, I mean, I'm not too worried about prints. I guess they're all over anyway, but. I would never stab him. If I had it in me anywhere to kill him, the least I could have done was make it humane as possible, or quick, or something, you know? I found, like, killing is humane, so to speak. I don't mean it that way, I just mean...
I know what you mean.
Like, he was still alive.
Yes, he was. He was alive for a while. And I knew that he'd been shot first, and he was still alive, and possibly tried to get away, maybe even tried to fight back.
I think he was in shock. Mm-hmm. I just remember waking up and...
But you didn't see him fight back or anything, did you? He just kind of collapsed there and...
No, he was here. By outside of his shower.
Yeah. And then you pulled him this way, you tried to get away with him, but then he couldn't go any further.
He said he couldn't move. He couldn't feel
his. And that's the last place you saw him. You said that he stopped and kind of collapsed right there. No. She was standing there, and he was over here, and it just doesn't make any sense.
He was still, like, able to move. He was all conscious up here, sort of, still. But he wasn't, like, on his leg or on his knees or on his feet. He wasn't walking.
He's crawling.
Yeah, I'm trying to think if I want to guide him from there. He was sort of using his legs, but he wasn't standing up.
Yeah. If you're going to continue on that route, I don't think I'm going to go any further.
I don't remember what time I left, but...
I gave you an opportunity. This was your only opportunity. Okay, and you just... Yeah, you gave me the information that you were there, but I knew you were there. And then you throw some story in that is not plausible. It just doesn't make any sense with the evidence that was there at the house. It doesn't make any evidence at all, or any sense at all. That evidence tells a story. And nowhere in that evidence does that story that you told me match. Is that how you want to leave it? You want to stop here, and that's how you want to leave it?
I know that I didn't take Travis's life. And I know that you don't.
I know you did.
Look, I know you don't believe me.
I don't believe you.
As long as I am here, someone else is happy. And it's not them.
So you're just going to let these two people get away with it?
There's not even any way to identify them. One was male, one was female. They were taller than me. Not by a whole lot.
Okay. Are you ready to go back?
Yeah, I guess I'd still like to say something to his family, but I don't think I have anything that could bring them comfort. Maybe I could write them a letter.
Oh, you always have that opportunity to do that, so.
Would they receive it?
I don't know.
I don't mean would they accept it. I mean if it made it to them, would they get it? Do you know?
Yeah, I don't have their. I'm not going to provide you their address.
I know his.
They know where you're going to be, and if they want to make contact with you, they can do that.
That's fine. I know his grandmother's address, and I guess if I could mail it, but.
Well, let me see if I can get someone to take it back. You're absolutely sure you want to leave it like this?
I don't know what else to say.
That's it then. Okay, the next time I see you will probably be in Phoenix. Is that cool?
I have a choice.
Well, you're going there regardless, so it doesn't matter. But I was hoping that we could resolve this here. And it's obvious by what you're telling me you don't want to resolve this here.
I just can't.
Well, at the beginning you told me that you couldn't tell me because you couldn't tell me who they were because you didn't want your family to get hurt.
I can't let my family.
And now you're telling me you don't know who they are. And therefore, it doesn't matter. So there's nothing you can tell me.
I can give you the
so
best
many
description.
Inconsistencies that I don't even want to deal with right now.
Okay, I just don't want
okay.
my family to get hurt.
Okay. They won't get hurt. You're hurting them right now by not telling me the truth. That's what you're doing. Okay? Okay, I just talked to the other detectives and they're gonna take you back here in a second. Okay. That's for me.
Jody, they ran across the street to get you something to eat. You're probably hungry by now. So I figured in the meantime, while we're waiting and you're just kind of sitting here and hanging out, if you want to drop that rough draft to Travis's grandmother or family, this would be a good chance for you to do that.
Well, it'll just be a rough draft.
That's fine.
Can I take it back with me? So I can use it to work on a final draft?
Yeah, we can work something out, yeah.
Visual.
You all finished up?
Well, for now, I guess.
What's that?
For now, I guess. Can I take this or no?
Well, let me just see. Make sure you're not, you know, sneaking jail secrets out or something.
Okay.
Take some paper with you. Where'd you put it?
Right here in my pants.
Did you write anything on it?
No. Can I see it?
Yeah. Hey, Chris, could you take a paper? Just take a quick copy of that.
Mm-hmm.
And stick it in your pocket. If it will stay there, and stand up for me. Put your hands out in front of you. And do the belly chains very often. Okay, you ready to go?